Ladies and gentlemen, let us talk about rate limiting. This time, not in Spring Boot, but in Nginx. So we still have a Spring Boot application. So if you are, if you like Java and Spring Boot, then it will still be fun for you to watch this video right here. But the situation is, you have probably seen this this drawing here sometimes now, if you have been following my rate limiting and throttling series. And the problem we try to solve is quite easy. Too many requests. What should happen? We have seen how to Spring Boot can handle it with the Guava library from Google, which is really, really cool. We've also seen how it can be handled with Spring Sue. Now the time has come to actually configure Nginx instead. So what we want to do is, if an evil bot or a good bot or maybe a user or third-party system, in this case it actually doesn't matter, we want Nginx to see when we have too many requests, then we will give her a response. We will not give a 429 this time, we will actually give a 503 instead, service unavailable. That's actually what it will give that, and that is because that is the default error from service temp unavailable, something like this. So this is the error, and this is because this is the error that that Nginx will give us by default when we have when the limit has been exceeded. And again, this time the limit is per IP address, or at least that's what I'm going to set up. There's plenty of other ways to set this up, but I'm using the documentation from Nginx, which is really, really good, and I'm using the basic basic scenarios. There's also actually some advanced scenarios where we can actually whitelist certain IP addresses and stuff like that. But with Nginx, of course, as usual, we can do a lot of stuff. But let us try to keep it simple. So what we're going to do is we're going to set up a rate limit of 2 per minute. Then the first request comes, and we will get this will be served to the Spring Boot application, and we will get a valid response back. We will get a spaceship returned. And now I'm a third party system, or I'm a user. And then the second time that we send this request, then Nginx will actually stop us and say, hey, you are spamming us with your requests, so the service is temporarily unavailable. So that is the response we will get the second time, or the third time is it actually. The two times it will go okay, and then the third time it will actually go bad. We will get this response. There's another thing, Nginx has a feature called burst, and this is very, very useful. That means that when I come the third time with my request, then instead of throwing this ugly arrow back at me, 503, then it can actually just queue me up, and then it can wait until the minute has passed, and then it can actually send the request to the Spring Boot application, and then send a valid response. This is awesome. So we can have something called burst, and that can be a number of slots that can be that's actually a number of queue slots. And I'm going to set this to 4 or something like that. That means that I can have 4 requests that actually are in a queue right here. When the 5th comes right here, then it will still get this error right here, 503, service temporarily not available. But the first 4, they will just stand here in a queue until the rate limit is okay again. And then we will actually get the response, because then it will allow the request to go to the Spring Boot application, and then it will go right here. Then there's something else. There's something called burst with no delay. Burst no delay, that means that we still have a queue system, so when the rate limit has been exceeded, then there's still a queue system. Maybe we say we have a burst of 4. That means that we can have 4 requests that actually take up these 4 slots. And what actually happens is that instead of actually putting us in a queue and having us wait, then it will actually give us, it will pass on the request, and it will allow the response to be returned right away. But the slots will still be taken until the rate is okay again. So that means that we'll get the response right away, but the slots are still taken. That means that now when the 5th request comes here and we only have 4 burst slots, then we will get this ugly message right here. So those three modes we have: without burst, we have with burst, where we are being put in a queue and we have to wait with our requests before it's just being playing through Spring Boot. And then we have the burst no delay, where we are getting the response right away, but the slot is still taken. Did it make sense? I hope so, because now we're going to see it run in a good real-life scenario. And when that's a real-life scenario, it's my own local imagination right here, and it is with spaceships, and yeah, as usual. So let me just close all the files that I've opened right here. First of all, I have created this project by pressing File, New Projects, Spring Initializer, Java 11, yes. Java 11 right here, I've chose Gradle right there, Gradle project, I've ticked off Next, and ticked off Lombok, and found the Spring Web, next finish, no database, no advanced stuff, just Lombok, of course, that is almost, that is a need to have, right, because then I can create the spaceship data class right here, and I'll get my getters, my setters, I'll get my equals, and my hash code, and to string methods, boilerplate coded, automatically generated, and then I also have my NoArgs constructor that will be generated, and my AllArgs constructor that will be generated for me, so I have a lot of code that will be generated for me. Thank you very much, Lombok. Then I have my spaceship risk controller right here. Request mapping API space, and then I say get mapping with the /, right here. That means that if I go to API space and then /, then I'll get this spaceship returned as JSON. That is the response, right? I have already started up my application. I have created a script folder right here, and we can actually run, we can hit the application directly with this script right here, and then just to see that it actually works. This is without using the Nginx, and we can see that we get this spaceship right here, model pyramid and fuel 86%. Now the cool thing, now the Nginx part. Let us go to the configuration. I have created a Docker Compose file right here, which this is Nginx custom, that is just the name that I chose, and then I'm building inside the Nginx folder, which I have located up here. And I need to share the network with the host in this setup because I'm running local development right now. Then I have my Docker file, which is from Nginx latest, and then I copy in my own Nginx configuration into the Docker image inside it. So that is the setup. That is how we're going to do it. That is definitely the easiest way to set up Nginx with your own configuration. And this is what we're going to talk about. This is where we have the magic. This is where we have our limitation, because if we go to the HTTP section right here, we have the HTTP section right there, then we can define a new limit. So I'm defining my own limit right here, and I'm saying that this limit should be based on remote address. That means that the request IP address is what will be this limitation will be based on. Then I'm creating a zone. This is something I just make up, Mike's limit zone. That is the name right here, or just Mike's limit. That is the zone. And then I say use 10 megabyte of my disk to actually store data about IP addresses and how often they are hammering the server, or how often they're sending requests. And 10 megabyte, the documentation from Nginx, let us just find it. It says it's like 160,000 IP addresses. It says it's right there. So 1 megabyte is 16,000 IP addresses, and 10 megabyte that they also used in the example is 160,000 addresses. Let me just zoom in a little bit like this. 160,000 addresses that will be stored right there. Then I set a rate of 2 requests per minute. You can also, all the examples from Nginx shows per second, of course. That is a more real life scenario, but so I can show you what's going on, and to show the principles, then per minute is much more reasonable in our situation right here. So 2 requests per minute, or else we will get the 503 service temporary unavailable. Then I've created this upstream server farm here. It's actually not necessary, but now I've created it. That means that I could have multiple servers right here. I only have one server, that is my own, and then port 8080. That is where my Spring Boot application is running. And so this is my alias right here. And then I'm actually setting up my server right here. I listen for port 80. Server name is Spaceship Server. I have added this to my local host file, so that means that when I try to hit this, then it will just go to 127.0.0.1 as IP address. So that means that I added this to my host file. I'll show this in a minute. Then I've said that if we go to location API or anything beneath that, then first of all, apply Mike's limit. That's step one. And also proxy pass to this farm that we have up here. I know it's only one server in the farm, but it's just to have a real-life configuration. So that is how the setup is. Let us go to a terminal. And the host file I was talking about, bi, etc., hosts like this. It was this line up here. I've added 127.0.0.1, and then I added spaceship server right there. So that is the one there that this Nginx will work on. And then I can write docker compose. I want to write down first to make sure that the server is not running. It's not. Then I want to write build, because then we are building the image and we are copying in the custom nginx.conf file. Oh, it looks really, really cool. And then we write up. And then we start a container based on the image that we just created. And it's actually running right now. We cannot see anything right here, but when we start hammering it with requests, then we can actually see that something is happening. Because I have another script right here, curl ship nginx, and inside that we have curl spaceship server / API / space. And I'm not mentioning anything here, but I could write 80, right? So when I don't write anything, then it's port 80. Let us try that now. Run. Oh, I got my spaceship right here. I'm so happy. And if I go to my terminal, you can see that we actually got the response. 200. I'm so happy. Thank you very much, Nginx, and my Spring Boot application, of course. Let me run again. Whoa, 503 rate service temporarily unavailable because now the limit was actually reached. Look at this ugly HTML message right here, right? But that is what we have programmed it to do, is that we can actually see here three limiting requests, and that is because I was also I was also sending requests before I started this video. This is number three, it says, so even though we have actually only, that must be because the file that has been used, I don't know. I would actually expect that I could have run one more, but let us change the configuration. First of all, I want this to be 5 instead, so we can actually send some 5 requests per minute. And then I want to add burst now. Burst equals to 20. Oh, let us see. Yeah, let us say 20. That means that now we have 20 slots for, yeah, let us just set to a couple actually. Let me just set this to 4. So we have 4 slots. So now we have 4 slots where we can be in a queue, and that means that we will just be delayed until the rate is then fulfilled again, or until we are below the number of requests per minute is below this limitation rate that we actually have set right here. Let me go out here now. I'm stopping the Nginx server. I'm taking it down with Docker Compose down, and I am building it again. That is, and then I'm writing up. Like this. Yes, now the array is running. Then I'll go to my curl through Nginx again, and let us just clear the buffer right here. I'll run once, pyramid fuel twice. And now already it's actually the limit has actually been reached. And now it could actually reply. Then I'll run again. And again, we get a delay. We get this delay right here. And we run again. And that, of course, is because, what did we say? We set it up to, okay, we actually have 5 requests per minute. That is one request every 12 seconds, right? Yeah, okay, so that's actually why we're waiting as we are, because then in general that means one request per 12 seconds. That's actually pretty good. That's a good example. Then we don't need to wait that long. I prepared some dad jokes because I was afraid that we were going to have to wait for a minute or so. But now you can see now we're actually being placed in a queue, right? So curl ship, run. And now we got it right away, run again. Now we are being forced to wait for 12 seconds and then it gives us the response. This is pretty awesome. Let us now try to change our configuration. First of all, let us set it to 4 instead. And then let us set it to no delay down here. Let me clear the buffer. Let us check down the Nginx server. Down. Let us build the Nginx server again so the new script will be placed inside the custom Nginx image. And then we write up. And now to rerun with the new configuration file. It is running now. Let us then go to curl Nginx like this, run. That is fine. One, two, twice, three times, four times, five times, six times. Oh, now we got service temporarily unavailable. And that is because the rate has been exceeded and we used the 4 burst slots that were actually already there, but it was, so we already, yeah, so this means that we exceeded the threshold, which is calculated on an error. It's the reason why we cannot just count and then it works as expected, that is because this is an average that has been calculated, right? And then we have the 4 slots. So we have the errors calculation plus the 4 slots of bursts. So that means that we have 4 slots where we actually get the response, even though we are not supposed to get the response. And the reason why this burst functionality is there is because applications behavior in general are like the common burst. Every time if I open a web page, then of course if we press let me just check right here, F12, then I can see in my network right here, then I can actually see here that I actually fired 3, there was actually 3 requests, so that's probably many more. You can see how many here. So this is why we have the burst functionality, right? Look at all the requests that we are firing in no time. Then when we are done with all these requests, then we do anything. Then we don't do anything. There's no communication. And that is why we have the burst functionality and the burst feature in Nginx, because this is the nature of applications. They fire away and get a lot of information and then they stop because now they're happy. And then the user can sit in his own slow pace and actually read the page right here. I hope all of this made sense. As usual, I'm going to place the code on my GitHub account. I think this is awesome and I think it's very easy as usual to set up Nginx. And I really like the documentation. It's really good. Really good documentation. So thank you very much for watching. And to the person who actually asked me about rate limiting, let me know if I answered your question in the comments, and thank you in general for coming with all the comments that you're leaving. Thank you very much. It makes me very happy, and then I have some new subjects for future videos. Thank you very much for watching. I have a great evening, and I hope to see you again soon. Bye bye.